Welcome to the Quantum World TV. Welcome everybody from all over the world, and we're very excited today to have back Dr. Yury Kronn. You know, we had so much demand after the last Quantum World TV about the subject he was speaking about, and this is very fascinating. And everybody wants to just more of Dr. Yury Kronn. I remember Dr. Yury Kronn is a renowned physicist from Russia. He studied with one of the most known university, famous university there, Gorky University. He also was an adjunct doctor, teacher, professor at the Moscow University. And in 1970, strangely, you know, he was at the top of his field. Dr. Kronn was asked by one of the leading scientists in Russia to participate in a series of experiments that indicate unexplained phenomena. And then, you know, something strange happened there, and I like he commented to us about it. So today we have him back. Of course, one of the exciting events, so he put together a course, Subtle Energy 101, and we already have a lot of students that are pursuing this class, where he not only overview, but more explain more in depth, you know, how work subtle energy, all this theory about the dark field, the dark energy, subatomic particle, quartz, subquartz. And before we start today, and I like he just overview what we just spoke the last program. And then this program, the next hour, we will be speaking also about how this applies to healing. Because I believe many of us, you know, this is what they are interested, how this can make a difference in our life. And this is where he's pioneering now, Dr. Yury Kronn, the creator, the inventor of what we call viral force technology. So he found a way to in some way work at the subatomic level to manifest a line of the products called the viral technology, where we can absolutely make a difference in the life and health of people. So welcome with us, Dr. Kronn, and please just review with us the basic that the student will be learning in Subtle Energy 101, SE 101.
So answering your question about my course, Subtle Energy 101, this course is about subtle energy, which is a modern name for the force which ancient called life force, which in my opinion is even more appropriate name for this force, because it's really, as we will see from many experimental data collected all over the world, that it really plays, I would say, programming role in all human and all living organisms functions on all levels, on physiological, emotional level, and mental level. So what is my course devoted to? First of all, to explanation what actually subtle energy is, where it's coming from, what is source of subtle energy. There are a lot of theories, modern theories about subtle energy, and they all want to present subtle energy as a byproduct of forces known to modern science. But many experimentations, and of course 5,000 years of experience of ancient scientists and researchers and philosophers, show that this force is not the product of our forces which are known to our science and which are shaping our physical world, but vice versa. This is energy which is coming from bigger part of the universe than physical worlds. We know that our science discovered already so-called dark matter world, which is 96% occupies 96% of the universe. And actually, it is subatomic world, and there are experimental confirmation. And that's what I in depth discuss in my course. There is an experimental confirmation that this force, this energy, is coming from subatomic world, which ancient called etheric world. It doesn't matter how we call it. The matter is that this energy is coming from the pre-physical world. And actually, it comes into three-dimensional world through basic particles of our physical world. And that force is creating these particles. So this is actually force of creation. In my course, I consider what subtle energy, how subtle energy interacts with physical matter to understand its action and made serious scientific research. You need to have at least have hypothesis about how it works. So I'm discussing different ways of interaction of subtle energy with physical matter and living organisms. And again, there are a lot of research done, especially in China, with influencing subtle energy on physical and chemical processes, which doesn't have any doubt in that fact that this force is interacting with physical matter, changing chemical and physical processes, and definitely influences our health. And in a sense, it plays a role of software for processes in living organisms. I consider, and I showed in my course some research which we did during 25 years of the research which I conducted with my vital force technology, which is capable to generate, record, and reproduce subtle energy patterns. And I demonstrated that actually any substance has its own unique subtle energy pattern. And that's how substances influences our body and all living organisms, as I already mentioned. Not only on chemical level, but also on energetic level. And taking into account that human body has also energetic structure, which ancient called acupuncture meridians and energy centers, called chakra in Indian science. So, ancient science. So, in this way, any substance produces not only chemical but energetic effect on a human being energetic system. And that's why no matter what you are using for healing, you always actually deal with subtle energy. And the more conscious we are dealing with subtle energy, the more successful we can be in our attempt to help problems which particular patient has. So subtle energy affects on many levels, as I said, and we demonstrated that it affects growth of cells, it affects mitochondrial activity, it affects even gene expression, which explains a lot of things which our science is puzzled with, like phenomenon of epigenetics. How environment influences activity of our genes. And we show that it's not, again, not only chemical influence, but also energetic influence, which means that energy of the environment is very important for us. And many experiments are showing that to consistently do research in subtle energy area, we need to have clean environment, and also clean environment, energetically clean environment is very important in healing process. So all these questions I'm discussing in my course, and many experiments are discussed, which are confirming what I just said about real importance of subtle energy in process of healing. And the most unusual property of subtle energy is its interaction with human mind. Many experimental proofs exist. And again, as I mentioned already, in China, in Institute of High Energy Physics, Chinese scientists conducted experiments which undoubtedly confirmed that Chinese Qi master, Qigong master, was able to influence even radioactive decay rate, and he could diminish it or increase it depending on his will, which means that human mind can program subtle energy to do the job, if you wish, which makes it absolutely unique among energies known to humanity. And if so, we understand that we can understand that this kind of phenomenon, like placebo effect, for instance, actually happens because influence of our mind on subtle energy, programming subtle energy in certain way, positively or negatively, to influence the outcome of effect of remedy, let's say. That's why there is a placebo, there is a nocebo. If a person negatively considers the possibility of influence of this particular remedy, it can be, its effect can be diminished, and vice versa, it can be increased. So it opens absolutely new possibility for conscious work with subtle energy, programming it and creating energetic remedies, which in conjunction with right chemical remedies could revolutionize, I would say, the medicine of our time. And I hope that it will happen soon, that our official science would be open pretty soon to research in this area. And it is very possible to do this research because, as I said and as I describe in my course, I created so-called, as we call it, vital force technology, which allows to repeat recorded energy patterns over and over again, which makes possible to satisfy all demands of modern science for repetition conditions of the experiment. And it opens unlimited possibilities for research and practical applications of subtle energy. So in this way, we can not only take into account ancient knowledge about subtle energy, but acquire a new knowledge and new technical methods of harnessing subtle energy for practical applications for human health and well-being.
Okay, so, you know, Dr. Kronn, you know, I see you as really a pioneer in the domain of natural medicine, healing, and when I look at your work, because you went a step ahead in some way with what we call today the vital force technology, which is your own technology. This is where you're pioneering now. In other words, you in some way resolve a huge challenge, you know, with this knowledge of a subatomic particle and what you're explaining in the course SO1. So, and then you came with the fact that we can imprint a mineral base with some pattern of information that can have an effect on health. And I know you run a lot of also your own experiment, you know, with a group of doctors and also assessing the heart variability and so on. You know, you are, when I look at you, you are the Hahnemann of this century. You know, this is what Hahnemann was trying to do, you know, doing this succession of substance and herbs and then try to inform, you know, a modern tincture, a base of alcohol And now, but now what you do it in some way with the knowledge of quantum physics. So this is very fascinating. Can you speak to a little bit more about that in detail?
You know, I started working on vital force technology 25 years ago when nobody thought about these possibilities yet. My goal was to give scientists a tool for real scientific research of subtle energy, and at the same time to develop technology which would be practically useful for developing, I would say, means of delivery of subtle energy to human being, not only to human being, of course, to anything. You can help with subtle energy to grow plants and heal animals also, of course. So in other words, I was working hard on delivering very versatile collection of energetic formulas for research and practical applications. And that's what I came up with finally, which is called vital force technology. Vital force technology is based, I don't want to go into details, it is in my course in much more details, but briefly, vital force technology is capable of producing, formulating, I would say, specific subtle energy patterns, recording them and reproducing them. Among these methods, we have also methods of copying energy of subtle energy patterns of any substance, which makes it also possible to create, let's say, energy patterns connected somehow with healing properties of substances which are even not are consumable. For instance, paramagnetic materials or precious stones and so on and so on. Creation of these patterns, we developed methods which allows us to record very pure subtle energy patterns. It's like creating a hologram. If you create dirty hologram, you have not clear image. It appears that it's very important to create subtle energy patterns without any electromagnetic noise present in it, or I will say as low as possible noise. And that's what we developed, methods of recording these energy patterns with very, very low noise. It allows us to reproduce very clearly and consistently subtle energy patterns. We also developed methods of reproducing energy of, let's say, periodic table elements purely electronically using certain vibrations of plasma controlled by electromagnetic field with frequencies connected to electronic transitions in atoms. We practically showed that it is possible to create energies connected to specific periodic table elements, and it opens absolutely new possibilities. For instance, you can produce the same effect as this chemical element on some functions of human body without having a negative effect, which a chemical part of periodic table element is producing. And the most common example of it is lithium. Lithium is very good for depression. As you know, lithium is prescribed for people who have severe depression, but at the same time, chemical part of these elements produces not pleasant negative effects, including, damaging liver. While energy, as we showed in our experiments, energy of lithium reproduced by our equipment, recorded and infused into concentrated trace minerals, produce the same psychological effect without any chemical negative chemical consequences.
That's incredible. It's incredible to hear that. So in other words, it's like you could avoid the secondary effect, you know, of that substance. And then I think you was also running some experiment with heart variability with some of that these substance, right? Can you comment about that?
Yes. Yeah. Yes, we did standard, you know, research with the help of many doctors all over the world we are working with, and they used such equipment as you mentioned, like heart rate variability, which allows to see general effect of this particular energy pattern on human body, on the autonomic nervous system, which is the main computer of the body, if you wish, and if it improves how your main computer works, it means that it's good for the body. And we did a lot of, we had a lot of research from doctors who were using our different energy patterns produced by vital force technology for different applications and seeing positive changes in autonomic nervous system, improving parasympathetic nervous system, calming down sympathetic nervous system, making balance between sympathetic parasympathetic nervous system, and so on. Yes, of course. And we did experiments with cells in different places, including Riga University of Latvia, where in the United States, in Beechtree Lab, which they observed effect of subtle energy on growth, viability of cells, or if its effect supporting of cells even in toxic environment. They observed also changes in genes expression, but after exposing this liquid where cells were growing, exposing to vital force formulas. So we developed the whole method of, I would say, delivering this subtle energy to living organisms.
So my question would be also how much stable was this information once these substances are programmed or, you know, reinformed? Because what I found today, you know, with homeopathy and all the new environment we are exposed with, you know, EMF and X-rays and heat, and everybody knows that you know, homeopathy in some way can be destroyed by heat. You know, some are really asking question about X-rays because most of these substances now go through carrier and they go through X-rays. And then, of course, you know, not only that, you know, any homeopath will know that, you know, you have to avoid mint, you have to avoid. So there is, it feels that sometimes the information that was created in the past with through the route of a homeopathy, you know, the succussion and the dynamization is pose some problem of stability. So how is stable the information that that result on vital force technology?
That's a very good question. As we know, homeopathy is also energetic method of delivering information. Subtle energy is involved in this recording of information in the substances and of substances by homeopathic methods, or this SACAM, as you know. And the homeopathy has great achievements and very good information sometimes presented by homeopathic remedies. But problem is that signal recorded by homeopathic methods is pretty weak, and that's what causes that vulnerability, I would say, of homeopathy remedies, as you mentioned it. And I heard about these from doctors from many countries. And another difficulties at our time of using homeopathic remedies is that very often human beings now have kind of diminished energy of their energetic structure, and it also influences how homeopathic remedy are effective. That's what we wanted to overcome. And what we did, we are recording very powerful energetic patterns. And information recorded in these patterns is very stable because of that. And by the way, we can help, and we are helping people who are using homeopathic remedies in two ways. First of all, we can re-record, if you wish, homeopathic remedy and make it much more strong, which prevents it from being erased, like, let's say, going through x-rays in airport, like you mentioned. And also, when people are taking specific energetic patterns for supporting their energetic system, it helps them to better, I would say, assimilate homeopathic remedies and being and for homeopathic remedies being more effective. It's like, you know, when you have a receiver and signal is very weak, receiver cannot receive the signal. If you enhance this signal, receiver can receive it. And also you can, if you wish, improve quality of the receiver. That's what we are doing. We improving energetic system of human being from one hand, and from another hand, we can reproduce energy of homeopathic remedy with much more strength, if you wish. And then homeopathic remedy becomes less vulnerable and more effective.
Yeah, and I can support that this in some way. We have worked in, a project, an experiment where we have a implement what you're speaking about, you know, reinform a homeopathy, enhance the signal. And the outcome now that is observed is very interesting. You know, we have a lot of result, and this is opening totally a new field here. So in other words, vital force per se, you know, has already, be able to imprint a lot of information with, you know, a substance that address health issues, but we can also transfer this also to complex homeopathic that also can be re-enhanced, less, more stable, as you said, more absorb, increase the absorption of the information. This is very interesting.
Right.
I think we are now opening a really new world here, because one of the main arguments, you know, if you go in the scientific community and as a doctor, you know, because I'm practicing homeopathy for someone many years, and most of the time, you know, they look at you with a smile saying, oh yeah, there is nothing in this substance. Now, based on what you are teaching in the subtle energy 101, based on the fact we are implementing a principle of quantum physics, I believe, you know, this signal or this this technology will be much more convincing that homeopathy is at the eyes of scientists. How you feel about that? Do we have an argument
yes.
there to be more respected?
Yes.
You know, because you already done experiment with heart variability. There is already some clinical result, with. You know, the technology using now for over 20 years, and then it seems also that with homeopathy, you know, we are getting a lot of positive result. But I think it's some way this will be much more acceptable to a scientific community, because now we have a rationale that at least, you know, they can refer to, which is quantum physics, you know, subatomic particle. How you feel about that?
I hope you're right, Dr. Paul. As I said, we are looking forward for our scientific community to accept subtle energy as a real phenomenon, mm-hmm. not as just, you know, hypothesis. Because, as I said, we have technology which allows do experiments totally following all the rules of modern science. When you use human being as a source of this energy, like Chinese did, which are wonderful experiments, but unfortunately, science very skeptically looks at it because, you know, it is not measurable energy, and that's why you cannot be sure that a human being radiates, let's say, the same energetic pattern this moment and next moment and tomorrow. There is no way to control repeatability of the experiments, but with vital force technology, we can reproduce the same energy pattern with 100% accuracy as many times as we want. And in this way, we can record even energy of this Qigong master and repeat this energy pattern as many times as we want for this particular scientific experiments. It makes it very researchable, I would say, now. And subtle energy, I hope that all these results of influencing cells growth and gene expression and everything else, which I already mentioned, will open eyes of our scientific community to this, because it's very important that all this research, as any kind of medical research, demands a lot of resources and money, actually. And so far, there is no support for science of subtle energy yet. And I hope that it will be more and more understood by scientific community that it is necessary to do, because we cannot make further progress of medical science without taking into account of healing and damaging effect of subtle energy. Because if, as I said already, if energetic environment, for instance, is not good, it can diminish effect of any kind of healing modality. And we need to take into account both positive and negative possibilities of effect produced by subtle energy and take care of conditions of our healing work, and also use positive information encoded in subtle energy as a medical tools along with regular chemical or supplemental remedies.
Okay, you're opening two doors here, and one I want to go a little bit deeper in it. It's like, you're speaking about what we say, be able to reproduce the signal. In other words, let's say we have here end form, different products with different, you know, intent, you know, and you already have done a lot in with your fossil vital technology, but also if we do the same thing with homeopathy, meaning that any of these products, either homeopathy or vital force, you will have, you can measure a different kind of signature for any of them. This is what you're speaking about?
We cannot measure of them. As I said, this energy
or indirectly.
But we can record and reproduce of them. So we cannot say what this pattern is, like we can say about electromagnetic, energy patterns. We can say about electromagnetic energy, oh, it has so many frequencies with such and such amplitude at each frequency and so on. But we cannot say that about subtle energy. We cannot measure it. There is no yet.
Yeah, but you can indirectly see that there is.
But indirectly,
a signature. Yes. Everyone has a reproducible, yes, and different signature.
Right, right. You can reproduce the same energy pattern, and you know that you're reproducing the same energy pattern and observe the same range of, let's say, physiological effect. So it's the only way, in my opinion, to research subtle energy now. It's phenomenological way. We need to observe how it works. We need to figure out algorithms, if you wish, how it works. Use this algorithm for producing desirable effect. And this is very possible way of developing subtle energy medicine in the future. And this energy medicine, which you, as you know, more and more popular, should be oriented exactly for this purpose. When we know these algorithms, how these particular energetic patterns influence this and this particular problem, and how it can be used in certain modality in combination, let's say, with other modalities, it tremendously enhances effectiveness of healing.
So, but it's a huge advancement here, because, you know, this is not what we were able to do previously with if we take ordinary homeopathy, because it's all the time the same problem. You know, not only people are challenging what is in the granules or in the liquid, but they are so challenging, you know, if you have the same products on the shell, do they have all the same outcome, the same signature? There was no way to measure that. So, and able to establish the what we call kind of a quality control, because this is what is a pharmaceutic, you know, at the end of the day, you have all these pills, but at the end of the day, you have to be able to have what we call quality control. Yeah, that was a big challenge, meaning that now with vital force technology, in some way, we address this very important issue, right? This is what you said.
That's right.
That's enormous. Right. This is incredible. This is huge. You know, we have there a very important answer to a tremendous challenge in the world of subtle energy. The other one is the other door is we can affect the genes. Can you comment a little bit more about this? Because everybody's speaking about this today. You know, they come with all these different techniques, and here we are able to change. Well, yeah, but how good it is, you know, how much you want to alter the genes, because you're playing with, with a very sensitive structure. So, you know, many, I guess you can also have nocive effect on the gene, you know. That's how you deal with that problem?
Why we started experiments on gene expression, because, as you know, like literally just a little bit more than 15 years ago, this new science appeared, which is called in biology, which is called epigenetics, which researched how environment influences our gene expression. And this gene expression even can be inherited by next generation. So mechanisms of this effect is not understood in full, of course, and it is very important to understand. And what we start doing many years ago, we start experimenting of how, let's say, to overcome a negative effect of energetic pollution on healing process. We did experiments with Professor Joy Jones in Irvine University several years ago on helping people, on helping energies, on creating energies which are capable to help cells damaged by gamma radiation. And what Dr. Joy Jones discovered, that effect of these energy patterns tremendously depends on how clean, how energetically clean is environment in the lab. And it appeared that it is possible to create energetic pattern which helps to clean environment. Then we realized that if so, this effect has direct connection with epigenetic phenomena. Because if we change the environment of lab, influence healing outcome, it means that environmental energy is tremendously affecting the processes in the body. And then we start looking, okay, does it influence also gene expression, which is the deepest mechanism of our physiology? So Beach Tree Lab, there were several experiments conducted which demonstrated that, yes, we can create subtle energy pattern for stimulating specific upregulation or downregulation of genes. And what we showed also that if we infuse subtle energy in some remedy, which already known for, let's say, upregulation of series of genes important, for instance, for immune system, we showed that if we infuse this energy, specific energy pattern into this remedy, we can enhance this process of regulation and also help to escape from down, let's say, undesirable downregulations of our genes. In other words, combining chemical and energetic effect on genes, we can develop absolutely new methods of treating different diseases.
Okay, so in other words, from we every healer or doctor listening now should be more aware of the environment they are working with, because it seems now with this electromagnetic pollution, EMF, and so on, we can be in an environment which is very anthropic, you know, for the body and consequently on the genes. So, and then secondarily, there is a way to also build defense mechanism, but upregulated, you know, the, or the gene, so in some way there is less consequence of them. So there's two components of what you just said. First of one, environment. So, because now, we have to realize nobody is really paying attention to it. You walk in clinic, you walk in hospital. Most of the time, these center of health, or where we treat, they are in the midst of a city, and they are all loaded with cell phone and you know that, you know. So, is it something that is from your research we have to really? When is this an urgent, but we really seriously more pay attention. Now this is the first phase, and then second, try to build our client that he can evolve without any dysregulation of their genes. So is I'm understanding very well what you're speaking about here?
It is not only on genetic level, of course, on all levels, as I already mentioned and stressed, subtle energy affects body on all levels, starting from genetic level up to systemic levels, like influencing immune system, autonomic nervous system, and so on, glandular system, all systems of our body. So it is possible. And what is interesting, you raised this question about electromagnetic radiation. In my course, I consider in details that subtle energy interacts with magnetic, electromagnetic field, through magnetic field. And it is important to understand that when we are affected, let's say, of this abnormal, I would say, for our body patterns of cell phones or cell phone towers, whatever, we are affected not only by electromagnetic energy, but subtle energy field disturbed by this electromagnetic energy. And it creates a lot of problems for the body because, as I mentioned, energetic system of the body, it's like a software of the body. And if you put, virus in this software, you can have sooner or later physiological or other consequences. Is it possible to use subtle energy to counteract this effect, negative effect of electromagnetic pollution? Yes, it is possible. And we did some preliminary experiments, and we hope that we will find support for further research. We found that, overexcitation of certain brain places, points in the brain which are overexcited by electromagnetic radiation from cell phone, can be calmed down by specific subtle energy if you attach some object infused with this subtle energy, let's say close to the phone or close to your head. So yes, it is possible to counteract effect of different pollutions, including electromagnetic pollution, using positive, good subtle energy patterns. But it just in the beginning, this research is just in the beginning. It's a huge area, and as I said, already it would be good if more resources would be devoted to this kind of research and to this kind of new modalities of protecting us from this growing electromagnetic pollution. You know, this Wi-Fi is everywhere now, and there are a lot of concerns how it affects us and especially children. And subtle energy definitely can be used for counteracting these effects. But as I said, this need to be seriously researched, and it is possible. It's very possible to create these tools for protection.
Interesting. Now, I'm doing also in another direction in research here in our lab, where, of course, we're speaking about negative EMF, but there is also out there what we call the pulse electromagnetic field. So, you have some unit that are used more resonating with the normal frequency of the Earth, accordingly more with the physiology. In other words, it's used a positive type of pulse electromagnetic field to help to, in some way, re-energize the individual. If, I'm listening at you here, but, what the study we have conduct is when we mix vital force technology or a homeopathy that has been informed with this principle with a pulse electromagnetic field, we are getting a lot of very impressive result. If we look at heart variability, there is some device now that I can measure heart variability, and they've done a reading of the stress level and so on, or the live blood analysis too. So is it something that can make sense with the research you already done? In other words, coupling at the same time positive pulse electromagnetic field with vital force technology to create a synergy of both here to restore health. Because, we have to understand, when these people are exposed to these negative energy for a while and they are toxic and now they get sick, to reverse or to reinform or reorganize the field of these people, we need kind of a synergy with different therapeutic to make that happen. Is that make sense with the research you done previously?
We have hints of possibilities, as I said, because we have just preliminary research, definitely. What I want to stress, that prevention of these kind of negative effects is especially effective, I would say, and much easier to achieve using subtle energy. And the sooner we will start research in this direction, and if resources would be available, it's very possible to do. I think it is possible to create the whole series, of devices, if you wish, using subtle energy for preventing negative effects of different kind of types of pollutions, including electromagnetic pollution. Yeah, it is possible. And it is possible to counteract negative effects, as I said, but to prevent them, especially effective methods of stopping these, developing of more and more diseases because of electromagnetic pollution.
And then I look at you know, the way you are cleaning the environment. You know, you were working with instead to use the classic path of the drop in the water. Now you use a vaporizer, right? So in other words, if you vaporize water that has been informed with vital force, you can affect. This is a medium that you are using to cleanse the environment.
Yes, it is kind of cleaning environment from electromagnetic pollution. I would say from effect of electromagnetic pollution. And as I said, we did research with Dr. Joy John in Irvine University. We showed that if we, how we know that it cleans the environment, only by observing effect of it. As I said, let's say success rate of experimental support of cells damaged by gamma radiation was much higher when environment of this lab was cleaned with this, like you mentioned, spray. Spray was informed with specific energetic pattern, and cleaning this environment with the spray produced very positive, dramatically, I would say, positive effect on healing of cells damaged by gamma radiation.
So in other words, you were spraying the substance in the environment, and then you were doing some type of indirect measurement of the effect on the physiology of the individual, right?
Right. It was in vitro experiment.
Okay.
Experiments on cells damaged by gamma radiation. Let's say 50% of cells killed by gamma radiation. We add this energetic pattern, and 30% of 50 of killed cells come back to life, which is real.
Wow.
Incredible results. But this positive effect happens only if you clean energetically environment. If you don't clean, only 10% successful experiment you will have in this lab. As soon as you clean environment, it jumps to almost 90%, which demonstrates that energetic cleanliness of environment is tremendously important for effectiveness of this healing process.
So can you also think that if we extend this medium to vaporize with other substance, or that we can also have an effect on the physiology? The target was to clean the environment, but then say, you spray it on the an individual, so you can expect that you will have also an effect on his energetic field.
Yes, we had reports from doctors who measured with the same equipment which you mentioned, heart rate variability, effect on nervous system and on autonomic nervous system of their patients, and just cleaning energetically environment in around the patients produced positive effect on his or her physiology. Yeah, that was observed.
Interesting. And I can also say, of course, this is on the order of experiment, but, is here in our lab, we can see also the same result. In other words, instead to just using a vaporizer of vital force technology of reinform a homeopathic substance, this is also giving some result. And as you said, we have to pursue the research. It's very important. But we are opening out again another door here that is absolutely fascinating because, it's like, suddenly energy doesn't need to go through that traditional route that medicine is using. In other words, the intravenous or the through the mouth for, or the transdermal, just only, spraying the environment, because this is very subtle, can already shift, the energy field of the individual. So that makes sense. And we are putting a tremendous door here to help individual, without you know, because now it's like, you know, any individual actually will be able to use this substance without in some way have to consult the doctor for a prescription and so on. You understand what I'm speaking about here? You know, it's like, it's not a, it's an unusual way to be able to restore health using a vaporizer, right?
Yeah, it's one of the ways, but I need to mention that, let's say, if you infuse some remedy, or let's say, like we did it a lot, experiments with infusing specific information with Southlander into trace minerals, using this insight is also, it's like non-invasive acupuncture. You have effect on all of your energetic meridians and points and so on, without needles, without anything, and it's internal influence. But as you mentioned, it is possible to use external influence also. As I already said before, if you put on your cell phone something which is infused with specific energy patterns, which helps to overcome effects or counteracts effect of electromagnetic pollution, it is also outside effect of subtle energy. So subtle energy can affect from inside and from outside. There are different ways and different advantages and disadvantages of using different methods. But you're absolutely right. It is possible to help people at least to enhance effectiveness of any kind of modalities which are applied to particular problem which this particular patient have. Just cleaning environment around.
Interesting. So yeah. It's like, you know, more we know about what is the vital force and this technology, we can see all the possibilities here, you know, where we can go out of the, you know, conventional ways, you know, to be a substance can be affecting the physiology. And now you speak about the acupuncture point. Classically, you know, we are all thinking about the needle, and here, of course, you know, this is the capacity, you know, be able to work on an acupuncture point with a needle is a privilege. But, you know, how much, you know, just be informed, you know, we can make a difference with the health of people if they know that, you know, you can just massage a point with a substance that can have even more result than a needle, and then, you know, it's not the whole painful and complex.
Yeah, but again, subtle energy infused substances can move acupuncture, I would say, on new level also, because when you massage point or you install needle in the point, it is just stimulation of this point without specifically programming it. But if you put, let's say, lotion infused with specific energetic pattern on this particular point, you can achieve desirable effect much faster and much more effectively. And we did this experiment in the past with the same professor, Joy Jones, in Irvine University, when he applied energetically infused oil on a point B67, which is responsible for vision, and also connected to vision. And he observed effect on occipital lobe using fMRI immediately after this application. And if you apply this not on the acupuncture points, effect was not observed, which means that this really energy infused in this oil was influencing acupuncture meridian. It opens new possibility for acupuncture too. Some people don't like needles, for instance, or children definitely don't like when
who like needles, right? Who like needles?
Yeah, right. So a lot of ways, I would say, of new ways we can even improve ancient ways, I would say, of using subtle energy like acupuncture. It's a lot of ways to involve subtle energy in the process of healing, I would say. And what is interesting, I need to mention that we observed its experimental fact, despite that it's not explained up to the end why it happens. But we know that energy, specific energy pattern, information encoded in this energy pattern, infused, let's say, in concentrated trace minerals, lives in this concentrated trace minerals for years, which makes these methods are very effective.
Incredible.
Very long-lasting, I would say, shelf life of these infused substances is tremendous. We did experiments with energy patterns infused 10 years ago, and they produced practically the same effect, and it was tested with heart rate variability. And it was blind test. The doctor didn't know which is 10 years ago infused, which is infused today. And the effect was almost identical. So, which means that these methods are very long living. This is a very long shelf life methods, I would say.
Incredible, incredible. Now we are getting at the top of the hour, and of course we will go for the chat room and the question. But I like really to point, you know, the importance of your research and your work. It's tremendous. You know, more I'm speaking with you, and more I'm digging in your course and everything. I realize now that we're making a shift. First of all, we're speaking about you know, technology that is more stable. Now I just heard that is even more long lasting. And not only that, it's like, you know, we can reproduce the signals. It's every substance has a signature. Now we're speaking in terms of quantum, in terms of quality control, which is essential to be able to move forward with any type of subtle energy technology. We're opening the door of, you know, how to reharmonize the environment, and how the environment is important also. From the point of view of genes, epigenetic, and so on. And now what is more important, and this is very in alignment for also with the university, is the language that in which, you know, we are you know, I was say, formatting that. This is very important, you know, because the way, you know, I spoke about this in my book, you know, when I don't think Hahnemann, I said, doesn't help a lot when he speak about the spirit-like force. And, you know, we have to come with, you know, in with the language of quantum physics.
With common language,
we have to
right.
come with a common language, because there is no way right. modern science will welcome any of these ancient system of healing if right. we don't modernize, you know, the foundation of that. And this is where, again, Dr. Kronn is pioneering, because, you know, he's in some way, I would say, not only the Hahnemann of this century, but he's also probably opening the door for Chinese acupuncture medicine. Because, again, you know, when I study myself, I become an acupuncture license in Canada. You know, I was in the College of Acupuncture was not speaking about all these vital force and chi and so on that is explaining Dr. Kronn in his course of subtle energy. Why? Because they were very uncomfortable with this idea of chi. They were just have kind of a bunch of recipes for pain and endorphin and so on. Now, you know, with this language and this new understanding how works subtle energy, we can absolutely, you know, extend all the understanding about, you know, this old ancient system of healing of Chinese medicine, of also Taoist medicine. So I like.
That's right.
I like to conclude now, because we are on the top of the hour, and then we will take also the question in the chat room. Thank you again, Dr. Kronn, and we're taking a pause here, and we're coming back with the question of our audience. Thank you.
You're very welcome. It's my pleasure to be on Quantum University.
We will oversee all the major concepts that are related to what we call quantum medicine, and now that I call the more creative integrative medicine. So I'm speaking from a point of view of a medical doctor that has blended integrative medicine, but all through this larger idea of quantum medicine, of quantum physics. And so the question is, how do you regain your full potential? You know, we have a view of subtle anatomy, subtle energy, and I was speaking about it. And then you have modality that can tap in this, and then can both can work together. But you're not looking for from a model that is limit to the materialistic point of view. You're looking from a model that is large, can integrate information, can integrate the full potentiality of the individual. This is very important. And what we're speaking about here is layers of information, layers of reality. You know, we are looking for more integration, we are looking for growth. And as we flow in this presentation, you want to understand also that it's not just about the physical. When we add in the next step, you know, the five elements, you will understand that organs are related with subtle energy. Someone who age with this idea of more integration, more, you know, resonance with all the energetic body and life, that kind of individual will tell you, you know what, you know, life get better more you age.
Sign up for this groundbreaking course today on quantumuniversity.com.
So before we start the chat room this morning, and you have the possibility to ask your question to Dr. Kronn and to pursue this interesting subject, I like, of course, introduce this new course, which is Creative Integrative Medicine Healthcare. And it's a very important program in the curriculum. Why? Because this is where we brought together all these concepts of subtle energy, and not only that, you know, because the idea of integrative medicine is more and more popular, and we can even see it in conventional medicine, but without a really detailed explanation how this this concept works and how they can be apply in different modalities, the integrative medicine will stay only superficial. And it's also in continuation of what is the subtle energy 101, because again, I speak in this course, this program, something very important. It's about coupling different layers of information, different modality together to create a synergy that allow really to shift the physical to the notion of subtle energy. So you are welcome to listen to this class. If you are a new student, you contemplate to sign in our program, of course, this class will be available this month. This is absolutely a gift for you. And if you're already a past student, please, this will be also part of your curriculum. You already graduate, or you're in the process to graduate. This course will replace what we call homeopathy training previously. So this course is really, I would say, the result, the outcome of all the last years, last 5 years, where we have tied together so many approaches, so many concepts and paradigms. So let's pursue our program this morning, and let's go to the chat room. And of course, we have already many questions. And please, you know, participant, we invite you to ask your question. And here's one. The first question, instead of imprinting subtle energy on an infuser, could they be used directly on the body to affect health? And is this infusion safe? Yes, so yeah, that's a very interesting question, because as soon as we have started to work with this idea to imprint information in substance, I guess there is many modality to use them. So how you will comment that, Dr. Kronn?
It's a very good question. Some doctors are promoting now using direct infusion, if you wish, energy into people. And I think it's very dangerous.
not because subtle energy by itself can be harmful, but even if you have wonderful, perfect energy for one patient whom you are treating, this subtle energy propagates everywhere. It goes through, walls and even through metal. And that's why you are infusing everybody around. And let's say if you are a doctor, you're infusing all your staff, and you are doing it continuously with each next patient, and it can be overloaded at least, or this particular energy pattern will not be good for everybody, of course. It's difficult to expect. So this method, I think, is not safe. Not safe, as I already said, not because subtle energy by itself is something dangerous, but because you need, like with everything, any remedy, you need to give this particular person what he needs, and don't expose. You don't give pills which you prescribe to this particular patient to everybody around, right? It's the same with subtle energy. When you infuse it into substance, then you can, determine with all testing methods available what particular energy pattern is good for this particular person, and don't expose to this energy everybody around.
Yeah, thank you very much. And I like to comment on that because this subject is very dear to me because I'm here in America now for 15 years. And there is this kind of a common knowledge where, subtle energy has no side effect and, no matter what, the body will take what it needs. And as a healer and also as a doctor and a scientist, and has been trained, in a model of medicine, of course, that was more disease-oriented. We have previously, before we chose our substance, to process to some kind of evaluation. So, and this is where, the training and the formation process fit in. It's very important. This is why we have designed this curriculum on the university, where we train the student not only to master and understand these concepts, but to implement them, and also how to read the individual and be able to be able to adjust this different subtle energy. And what is the challenge there? And I wrote this in the book, Creative Integrative Medicine, is the evaluation of an integrative, creative integrative doctor, we'll call it a quantum doctor, will have to be based not what it was before, and sometimes parameters that determine the disease, but parameters that are more in terms of bioterrain, parameters that will try to build the full potentiality of the individual. So there is a process there, it's like anything else, where this is where our students go through, from bachelor to PhD. They familiarize themselves to this new paradigm of medicine that is not defined by a genetics, a biology of disease, but a biology of health, and so on. So there's many concepts, that are, floating around, and that has to be bring in an effective, I would say, model of healing, where the student is aware of what he's using and, proceed to some kind of evaluation, not in terms of disease, again, a term of health. So, this is very important. Another aspect, and I think Dr. Kronn will agree with that, subtle energy, vital force technology can be, used as a little bit like a homeopathic substance, but also can be spray, can be also imprint in crystal or other substance. Of course, we have seen that previously in the other program. This is very important. I like to, remind you, this is what I said at the beginning of this program. Dr. Kronn is kind of the Hanuman of this century, because more and more we start to evolve in this idea and scrutinize how works subtle energy, we also reinforce the efficiency of the substance. You know, I'm not saying homeopathy was not efficient, but you know what we discover now, we can be more even efficient with substance than we were before. And then because that, of course, we have to know what we are doing. Thank you.
You're exactly right.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Here another question. If subtle energy affect genes expression, would it be possible to activate genes we have never seen before and enhance what it means to be a human? This, you know, this is another very subject, because everybody today say, oh, and I found a way to change genes and all this and that. So what is your take on that, Dr. Kronn?
Oh, you know, we are just in the beginning of this kind of knowledge. If you look at genetic research all over the world, it's millions and millions of dollars spent on it. And we, with our very small resources, what we can only state right now, that yes, subtle energy affects genes expression. And we can see that specific energy patterns stimulate genes expression, so up regulate gene expression or down regulate gene expression. So that's only thing we know right now. To answer this question, how specifically affect genes, it should be science of the future. I hope that our mainstream science will realize that this is a very safe and right way of influencing gene expression with subtle energy. It's much safer than with chemistry, and it has big future. But for right now, of course, we cannot answer this specific question, how to influence this gene or this gene and this way or this way. It's, as I said, we are just in the first small step of this research, and we are not capable to do this research. We don't have genetic labs. So it is a matter of the future.
Yeah, it's another very important question, you know, because I remember as a medical doctor when I studied, in the medical university and biology and, of course, the genetic evolution, this was such a core subject. But I didn't realize at that time what are all the consequences on that, and ultimately on the model of treating and healing. This is very important. You have to understand now that between the new biology designed by some of our eminent professor like Dr. Amit Goswami and Dr. Bruce Lipton, and we have also at the summit this newcomer that everybody know, Rupert Sheldrake, morphogenetic field. The model of genetics is completely reviewed from another angle. You know, and you have to realize that, and you will see that in the next decennies, is two tangent, two kind of option. One will be, and this is where is a heading more conventional medicine, a model of looking at genes in terms of a deterministic fatality. In other words, you go to the clinic, they read the map of your protein, and here you may have this disease or that disease accordingly to your ancestor, and here we have a surgery for you, or we have this pill for you. You see, you have to understand the consequence of that. And now, on the other side, you know, if you look at what is saying Dr. Amit Goswami, Bruce Lipton, and Sheldrake, is now this is not the end of the story, because it's like it's not just looking at the materialistic point of view of the gene, which is like a band of proteins, you know, that in some ways kind of dumb, because there is no intelligence there. What is coming new is the expression, you know, of the genes. You know, it's like, and Bruce Lipton would say, your biology, your belief system, the way you think, your environment, and this is where epigenetic come in, and then even Dr. Goswami pushed a little bit further the boundary of that in what we call the field, you know, and then Sheldrake will go even further when he speak about morpho resonance. So the question is not just about changing this you know, materialistic, what we know about the genes in the cell, but the expression of the genes. And here you will have again two paths. If you stand in this model of creative integrative medicine, it's like, yeah, there will be a way to shut down or work more at the, tell me if I am wrong, Dr. Kronn, but it work more at what we call the expression of the gene. It's not changing the brand of the protein itself, because I don't think you can do too much there. Maybe you can do something there, but it's very mechanistic. But the strategy would be also to change how this gene expressed. Doesn't mean because your ancestor has this and was thinking this way and or generate that you are doomed to do the condemned to express that. And this is very important. And you can realize now the what would be the outcome. You know, in one path, you will end like with this drama situation we saw a few years ago, and I respect her very much. You know, she's one of my favorite actress, Angelina Jolie, where she go, you know, for a dramatic surgery, because now she went in a clinic and she has this reading of the genes, and here I will have this, and or the other path where, yeah, I have these genes, but, you know, so what? I can probably do some different other approach, some subtle energy work and so on, that this doesn't get expressed. And this is where the lesson is very important. You know, we're heading to two type of medicine. One just materialistic, mechanistic. The other one is more, you know, a feel of full potentiality, full expression of what should be the individual. So I don't know if you like to add something, but for me, this is very important because, you know, we think it's no consequence to think in terms of Darwinism, fatalistic biologic system. But yeah, there is a lot of consequence to think this way. Any comment about that, Dr. Kronn, or?
I think you're right. It's a much wider area than our science understands now. And the possibilities opened with using subtle energy for changing gene expression are tremendous. And then also, like you said, and like Rupert Sheldrake mentioned many times, that since we have connections, and since our words, our thoughts influence subtle energy action, we need to be careful even how we speak with patients, for instance. So it can, strangely enough, but it can even influence gene expression. But in terms of application, science of subtle energy for future regulation of gene expression, I think it's enormous possibilities there.
A very interesting question here. Have you done research work on human assessing their mental or psychological condition? This is from Ayub Fadil. And
I didn't understand what it
okay,
means.
Let me repeat that. Have you done a research work on humans assessing their mental or psychological condition?
Assessing?
Yeah, and let me maybe remind you, you know, when you were at this congress, I think 2-3 years mm-hmm. ago, and you've done this kind of mental experience, you know, where people will, you know, work, you know, you remember that? So.
Yeah, but, you know, it's a testing, I would say, psychological and mental condition actually has nothing to do directly with subtle energy. It can be done in many ways, and applied advanced kinesiology can be used for that, and you can, if you apply it carefully, sure, you can assess mental and emotional conditions of this particular person and many other ways, but directly to apply subtle energy to assessment of these conditions. We don't work in this area. We are mainly, as you know, oriented on creating energy patterns for specific purposes and understanding, of course, with our research, how subtle energy works and finding, I would say, algorithms of subtle energy actions and apply it practically. But assessment of conditions, whether it's mental or emotional or physiological, it's a different area. We cannot cover, unfortunately, everything.
Yeah, and just to complement that a little bit, is you know, in our model of curriculum, you know, we speak about this new subtle anatomy, and you, I think you saw a picture of it in the previews of my course, and it's very important. And then there, this is kind of where we start to lay out different, you know, different type of body, the vital body, which resonate more with is the work of Dr. Kronn, you know, where works homeopathy and all these subtle energy substance that can shift, you know, meridians and you know, the vital body. So I don't have time to go through all this. And then you have later on the mental body, which is where there is other approach that are more kind of resonating with that. You know, we are thinking in terms, you know, meditation, some type of breathing, yoga, auto-hypnosis, super learning technology, and of course, you know, as go the student in the curriculum, he is exposed to this a different alternative. Today, it's very difficult to be, I would say, there's so many approach out there, so to be enumerate all them. So what is important, I think, for the student is to have in some way a skeleton, a way to organize how you will use this modality regarding of what is, after evaluation, what you are targeting more. And this is something also I explained in this course I was that I introduced at the beginning of the program, you know, creative integrative healthcare training. It's like, you know, how you look at this multiple dimension of the individual, and what are the modality that resonate the most with that, and then, you know, how you can implement them. So it's another very important field. And here we have another question: is it possible to be provide with the link or reference to the latest scientific study experiment paper which are being spoken about from Dr. Kronn this evening? Thank you in advance. Absolutely. You know, this is why the course is designed. And our course are designed very precisely, where you have a lecture of Dr. Kronn, especially if you speak about subtle energy 101. And then you have also a reference and where you can get this information and the study that has been done. And I like to point again how important was the course that has designed Dr. Kronn, because in some way, it's a unique program, it's a unique class where we start to give some scientific ground, you know, to how works subtle energy based on the notion of subatomic atom, you know, subatomic model. And Dr. Kronn speaking this, you know, about, you know, not only his research, you know, but study that has been done, and not only by him, but, you know, you have hundreds of people in the field that are studying this phenomenon for 50 years. And we know, you know, everybody knows that, you know, Russia has all the time been a step ahead in the domain of this field. And of course, Dr. Kronn has a very high credential coming from Russia and has graduated there. And, you know, he is absolutely the one that can be the voice of this information. So this is why this course has been designed, and of course you can sign up. I suggest highly. A lot of people already, signed for this program to get a little bit further in the understanding of subtle energy. So let's, and then this is what you see now on the page here. So you can access this on our course site, Subtle Energy 101. And they can register from there. So, can you refer to research done in measuring human mental or psychology condition? Yeah, I think we have done this. Just a second.
Yeah. By the way, coming back to this question, Dr. Paul, I need to say that we need to understand that in the future research, subtle energy can be used for more precise determination of condition of mental and psychological states, because when you can use energy patterns which specifically designed and proven to be effective for affecting psychological and mental states, you can more, I would say, actively to do testing, because using this pattern and observing response of the human system, so that you can make much more detailed and precise conclusions. In the future, I think in this sense, subtle energy will be good instrument as an addition to any existing methodologies of testing.
Yeah, and now let's say this other question, which is also from Ayud Fadil, and I think this is where he was heading in the first one, so this is why the beginning looks like the other one. Can you refer to research done in measuring mental or psychological condition? Also, can vital force technology formula help guide using other energy medicine treatment protocols such as a laser Q1000? So in other words, the question is about, how could we associate, create a synergy with the laser therapy, and now he mentioned the Q1000, there's a lot of there, and vital force technology.
Yes, it is possible. Laser therapy can be even improved if those who use these therapies understand more about connection between electromagnetic and subtle energy. And let's say specific modulation of laser beams can be used for enhancing effect, combining effect of purely electromagnetic nature plus subtle energy, which is connected with this laser beam. And also laser beam can be used as a carrier of subtle energy patterns. And again, in this sense, combination of laser therapy with assigning to this laser beam specific energy pattern can tremendously widen spectrum of effect of laser therapy.
Okay, I'd like also to comment on this. I'd like to add, because this is very, it's a subject which is very important. And this is also discussed in the course I just designed, because it's possible, and this is very important, from my point of view, to be able to work with different modality that synergy them, create a synergetic effect, and this is where the class is there. It's like to give a map how to entangle that together. This is. We have done also some experiment at the university where this is what I call, this is a concept I call coupling, where you're coupling, modalities that are like more subtle energy with others that are more subtle, or, there is a way to associate that. And of course, at the end, you get a more efficient result. But again, it's not like recipes for everything, but it's like it helped the student how to work with that. And if we look at our graduate now, if you go on the website and you look how they reflect that in their practice, you will be amazed how our students associate therapies together. They come from different angles, they have different gifts, they have developed different interests, from autism to a thyroid problems to fatigue chronic to and so on, and they have learned how to conjugate different therapy together. And I think it's very important, because there is something out there that we hear all the time. It's like, if I have something acute or if I have a problem, better go to see the doctor, because this medicine works so slowly and they don't. They are not efficient, and they take time too. But now, it's because we were at a time where we didn't know, we were kind of apprentice now at that time, but and we didn't know how powerful are these modalities. And when they are synergy together, no, you can have a very substantial result and very quick in all the domain, from pain to degenerative disease to acute situation, and touch the root of the problems. With Dr. Kronn, by example, just if we think in terms of synergy, you know, we have developed through his technology, Vital Force technology, a way to also imprint homeopathic information. And we know homeopathy, you know, is already out there now for 200-300 years, but some way not efficient as it was, because electromagnetic radiation we were speaking about, and there's more pollution and so on. So there is possibility, you know, to reinforce homeopathy with this the synergy with the vital force. So and I think this is where is the future of this medicine, and where, you know, of course we're not speaking about acute, you know, emergency will be all the time an emergency, a car accident or something. But I think we will be able to address more chronic and acute in a very short time. And not only that can be more efficient than what we have at this time, like pharmaceutic, but will address the root and cost less. This is very important, because where is heading now healthcare? And it's another my favorite subject, you know that. You know, it's like, and I speak about that in my book, Creative Integrative Medicine. You know, we try to solve the problem in an economic way, you know, in a social way. In other words, we say, oh, you know what, healthcare, let's make it more social kind of medicine. Or if you are social, then, you know, you try, you know. But the real debate is not there. We have to redefine medicine, modern medicine and natural medicine, on a model that is costless. This is what is important, and not just address the symptom, but the core. This is how important it is. And one of the lines in my book is to say, you know, we don't know how much, what is the cost to have an incomplete model of education. So this is where everything is heading there. We are speaking this morning about Southern energy with Dr. Kronn, but at the end of the day, we're also speaking a type of medicine that would be more, that would be costless, more efficient, and give back in some way, the capacity to individual to manage their own health. They need tool for that. So I think this is very interesting subject.
You know,
and
I'd like to add that you're absolutely right, that what is good about subtle energy methodologies, that they are applicable to everything, and you can enhance practically any modality. But what I wanted to stress, that subtle energy approach is especially good for prevention. Like you said, we need to go to core of disease, and core is, you know, appears much earlier in subtle bodies of a human being, if you wish, before it manifests as a physiological disturbance. And preventing, changing, I would say, these energetic programs which create this disturbance in advance, it is very, very good way for creating new, I would say, new preventive medicine, which, of course, will also bring down the price of healing.
Thank you. Thank you for your answer. And now that's a very practical question, the cell phone question. And we know that out there, there's so many gadgets, you know, that intend to protect you against, you know, the bad EMF, you know. So what cell phone cover does Dr. Kronn recommend? There are so many, and one does not know which are really effective. Thank you, Dr. Kronn. Love to listen to you, Florence Tosh. So that's a very important question, because, you know, it's like we want to have more protection today. And cell phone is, I think, a huge, huge problem, you know.
Unfortunately, it's true. We have, you can go on, ask Google. Google knows everything. And Google will show you enormous amount of research, which lately shows how actually much more dangerous EMF radiation is for human health than we thought before. About using different, covers for telephone, it's not very effective. We didn't find anything which would really counteract the effect of electromagnetic wave on a brain, let's say, or on a subtle body. But we developed a specific energetic pattern which significantly diminishes effect of electromagnetic radiation on the brain. And if you attach this to cell phone case, any kind of case, it will help to do it. Of course, unfortunately, this technology goes forward very fast, and we will need in the future adjust these energetic patterns to new types of technologies. But for now, it demonstrated in some preliminary research that, yeah, it is possible to create subtle energy patterns that infuse it into case, for instance. We hope that in the future some cases will be, some case production companies will be using this kind of technology to diminish effect of electromagnetic radiation on the brain and on the other structures of the human being.
Thank you, thank you. And I think it's a very practical question. Another one here is, can we get smarter? and it's probably what I'm drinking this morning. You know, I thought I was kind of sleepy, and as we go, I have some kind of subtle energy.
Can you get smarter using subtle energy? subtle energy is a tool.
So it's from Robert Ensley. He said, if trace mineral can be programmed and then consume to internalize this subtle energy pattern, can be subtle energy pattern be programmed for enhancing performance for academic or special skill?
Yes, it is possible to help. It doesn't mean that you will get smarter just drinking subtle energy, but it can be used as a tool which enhances your ability to train your mind, let's say, to be more concentrated. Yes, we have energy which is called clear mind, and this clear mind, it was demonstrated experimentally that it improves scores of children who were going through tests, mathematical and spelling tests. It was immediate improvement. It doesn't mean that they became smarter. It means that they were more concentrated and more to the target of the test. So yes, this kind of help possible, but main thing that it can be used as a tool, and if people, let's say, meditate, if people train their concentration, energy can be helpful tool to improve, enhance, and speed up the process of this training.
Yeah, very, very interesting. And of course, you have to listen to the course of Dr. Kronn, Subtle Energy 101, to go deeper in this concept. And also the program, Creative Integrative Healthcare, where I go also in this idea. This is very important because this is where medicine is also heading today. We're speaking about anti-aging, and we're speaking about, all these baby boomers, they want to stay smart, and, of course, they want to maintain the level of brain vivacity and so on. So, it's explained, I go truly to this. It's very important because when we speak about full potentiality, of health, for some people, it's kind of abstract. So how this really land in practice? Dr. Goswami was speaking about a positive health, Deepak Chopra, perfect health. And when this is explained in this the class I designed too, you know, is how you integrate this in a process of not only personal growth, but how, you know, you can make all these different body, you know, more working more in unison. And I don't know if you just remember the clip we showed you at the beginning. I am saying, you know, aging should not give you the feeling that, you know, you have, you know, how do we say that? No regrets, but, you know, you have nostalgia about the past, that this was your best time. But should be more an experience where you say, you know what, life is even better than it was before, because I have, you know, I'm more integrated. I have more wisdom, intelligence to go, to understand in depth, you know, the human reality. And this is what should be health. This is what we speak in terms when we speak about a full potentiality. And of course, I guess this question this morning was specifically to learning ability, to also scale. Yes, it can be increased. Is in terms of performance, or is it in terms of integration? And this is where should go health. You know, the paradigm of health or disease, you know, in the last 50 years has evolved a lot. World Organization was saying, you know, what be healthy is not having disease. And of course, people didn't buy this now anymore. And then came along the idea of more energy you have, better you feel. And then as it goes, you know, we come with other concept. Now the whole paradigm now land on this idea of integration and full potentiality. And this is where stand you know, what the student learn at this university. And this is where it lands also in this new curriculum that we're speaking about. This is so important because, you know, in some way, if medicine is not redefined with more creativity, we end in avenues that has no issues. You know, it's just the answer is just we pay more, it costs more, and then at the end we're not even healthier. So we have to shift that. So this is a very very important question. So one is asking a very good question to you, Dr. Kronn. You know, what is the next step in Dr. Kronn research? What is your next step now?
You know, all depends on what and how other scientists, open-minded scientists, can collaborate with us, because we have enormous amount of ideas for new research and how to use subtle energy for everything, starting from like a testing, which we discussed, and for application for specific purposes. I think it is very important to understand that human being also, with his or her mind, can create specific energetic programs, if you wish, capable to do incredible things. And you know that power of prayer, power of affirmations is practically proved and clinically proved. We know that it works. But to understand mechanisms of that and to make it practical, it is necessary to do research with this kind of subtle energy created by human mind. And that's my dream for the future research, because it is enormous possibilities for training human mind to heal themselves, to heal ourselves. Because in this process, in understanding of these mechanisms, we can convert a so-called placebo effect into a very powerful tool of self-healing, preventing diseases, and so on and so on. That is the most interesting for me, besides all other ideas, as I said, which we have. And we are working with open-minded doctors on creating these kind of tests. And we hope that more and more doctors and mainstream doctors will be open to this kind of research And as I said, we have a lot of ideas how to do it, what exactly to do it. But this area of training human mind and applying human mind for self-healing and creating energetic patterns for healing other people is very attractive to me.
Yeah, thank you. There is a lot of future, you know, and of course the question was not asked to me, but I will choose also the opportunity to say, you know, for us at Quantum University is, you know, what is the next step is, you know, our mission has been, you know, to make this type of concept that is around subtle energy and, you know, and this new modality of healing available in a credible format where the student would be able to practice this modality on the field. And this is where we have, would be the outcome now. We have a student all over the world, as you know, and graduate every year. And this year we'll have also another graduation. And so that, I think this is a very important step because, you know, of course, there's a lot of research now. There is a lot of modality, but you know how this get on the ground of medicine and practice and clinic and wellness center, and this is where we need credential, and this is you know how society works, and the university was important for that, and then this year a very special event is the Summit of Integrative Medicine. This is unique in a sense, you know, 49 speakers. What this show. It shows that, you know, you have a collegiality now all over the world of thinkers of that align with this model. And then, of course, Quantum University is the voice of that, but it's creating another leap in the awareness of the world, you know, to have this event that, you know, everybody can participate free. Please help us, you know, you send link to your friends and we have also affiliate program that will rewards you if you do this. And in that event, this event has been designed in a very has been studied in a very specific way. First of all, we have these top keynote speaker that are all around the world, and we have other what we call the sponsor speakers that expose new technology and products. And then we have also, you know, a platform for our students, graduate, people who come with what we call the innovation, healthcare innovation. And we'll have a contest where these participants will be, you know, chose as the best innovation of the year, and then will allow this newcomer to be part of the faculty and also be participating to the next Congress. So this has been designed, it's a totally, you know, a new concept of event that encompass all the summit you can have seen online, because, you know, technologically it's very advanced. You know, with videos, and you have seen some clip of these videos. It's very unique. So when we think in terms of next step, it's like we want to create a worldwide awareness of what are the capacity and the creativity of these new modalities, and the summit is one of them. So I think this is an important step, you know, in the evolution, you know. Many events has been a step, of course, to go toward, you know, a society that will support more healing and so on. So I know I see the time now is just going. We have few questions left. You know, but before we go to the last question, I like also to honor this place we are now. We have a studio which is located in Hawaii that has really served us for the last, I believe, 4 or 5 years. And now we're moving in a new space, bigger space with more facilities. And you know, it's all the time my philosophy to be grateful, you know, for a place that has been so carrying so many blessings for us. So, and of course, you know, it also resonated with the fact that, of course, university is growing, you know, and we coming with, you know, of course, new facilities and improving everything, putting together also all the staff, you know, on site, you know, people in Hawaii. Now we have a huge team of people working at the Quantum University. You can see on the website now, you know, the entrance of the place where we are, and then you know, so yeah, this is and then the difference. So let's take another question here, which is about you know, one is about, you know, ask Dr. Kronn how he will couple Saturn energy with laser. I think we already addressed that. Yeah, it's possible. And of course, you can use, you know, when you do your therapies, you know, the client can have, you know, using this Saturn energy at the same time to synergy. The idea of homeopathy reinforced by vital force and energy also is very useful, because there is also this capacity to regenerate tissues. So and laser is about that too. You know, of course, there is a lot of approach for pain, but you also think in terms of regeneration. So this can absolutely be work together. And then the same. Participant is asking, where can we order Clear Mind for our children? It is an honor to listen to Dr. Kronn and Dr. Drouin. They're really very impressive and humble scientists, both of you. You know, I think there is a link on the website. Can you confirm that, Alexi, where they can have the information about, you know, how to access Dr. Kronn?
You know, this kind of energy formulas.
Oh, okay, can you go there below on the picture? Where is it on the website? And then, of course, Dr. Kronn can insert that.
We are distributing it only through practitioners, Dr. Paul.
Yeah.
So they want to find it. They need to find open-minded practitioners, alternative doctor who would contact energy tools, and then they can get this Clear Mind.
Absolutely. And this is done now. It's very clear why it's done, because it's not something you find on the shelf. You know, you need to have a kind of a comprehension, you know, how you use Saturn energy. Our students have access to this Dr. Kronn products, you know, because they are either graduate or they have the sufficient training to have that. So this is another way also to access. And I would suggest, you know, before you sign up with the course of Dr. Kronn, so you and the one I just designed will give you how you can entangle with other modality. This is a very good question. Another one is, say, hello Dr. Kronn, I have been typing trying to use your products to have a client with hormonal acne, but with no result. How can I approach this condition? What is the protocol? It's kind of a specific now. And I don't think we have time to go there.
Yeah, specific questions they would better send to us, and we will answer them.
Yeah, so send to you, and then again,
specifically.
Absolutely, and same thing. You know, if you go in my the last class I done, and Irene, I think you're already a student. So please, this is a must to review that class, so you will have an understanding how you can work with you know, Saturn
energy.
Yeah,
they can contact me, and I will answer, and our people will answer them. Yes.
And then I sent another question again. It's we have answered that. Is how we can integrate Saturn energy with other healing modality. How and where can the products be obtained? So I don't know, Marilyn, if you are a student, but you know, I think the first step will be either to consider it to sign in our program, where this course will be available for you. And August we have a special It's very special because if you sign up, you have this new creative integrative healthcare, and you will also have Dr. Kronn course without any charge, and so this is an entry. So then from there, you will be more able to see how you can mix all these modalities together, how this work, and have access to these new technology, which is very exciting. So I think we are at the end of the hour now, and I'd like to thank you again, Dr. Kronn, for your time and your generosity.
It's my pleasure.
And you have to realize it took months to put together all these precious information that you will find in the Subtle Energy 101. And so this is, it's really because Dr. Kronn is very busy, I'm telling you. So it's a precious course that is there. It's unique in a sense that it is the first of that categories, that you can find, absolutely. And before so I finish, I like to tell you that the next Quantum World TV will be about the health innovators. So in other words, we have at the summit, a contest called the Health Innovators, or the Best Health Innovation in Healthcare of the Year. And we had the participant to this event that will be presented. So meet our speaker competitor. And then, as you sign up for this a summit, you will be able to vote for them. This is very important. Can you scroll a little bit up here where we see the line, sign up and vote? Can you show that? It's very important. Because, what we create is something that is interactive. Sign up World Summit for free and vote now. So this is how you will be supporting, the best innovation of the year. It's our American idol at the Quantum University at the summit. It's more than that because, we believe that there is a very gifted student and very gifted healer out there that are coming with innovation. And for me, to put this summit of integrative medicine was not just to expose, give the platform to people we already know, but also the platform for the newcomers. A platform also where our graduate can express what they found. You should see their work. I'm exposed to their thesis now for a few years, and it's very impressive. And this is your chance to choose and honor the work of these students and vote for them. And then this is kind of unique. So we need all your participation to make this exciting. And doing so, you also, supporting, the advent of in healthcare, wellness industry of these concepts of subtle energy. Thank you very much, everybody, and see you at this next World Quantum World TV, August 29, 2015. So put this date in the calendar. This is when this event will happen. This is the first time we will do this, August 29, 2015. Thank you so much, everybody.